Hello, I'm Dev Poodle. Hello, I'm Dev Poodle. Hello, I'm Dev Poodle. This is a guide on Godot's rich text label node and the many different effects you can make with it. In case you get curious later, nearly all of the text in this video was rendered straight from Godot. So, Godot has two main ways of displaying text, the label node and the rich text label node. The label node is what you'd expect, just a standard way to render plain text. It gives you some settings for changing the font, size, color, or outline of the whole thing, but that's about it. What if, let's say, you wanted to change the color of only a few words in this sentence, or you wanted to make it bold, or something more fun, like having each letter move around on its own? Well, you can't really do this with a standard label node. That's where RichTextLabel comes in. It lets you apply all sorts of cool effects, including custom ones. RichText is essentially just plain text, but with modifiers. You get access to these modifiers when you create the node. Up here in the inspector, you'll find a BBCode enable option. Click it, and you'll gain access to all the effects the engine has to offer. So, where are they? Well, BBCode is a type of markup language. This means you include the effects you want to add in the text itself. Like if you scrolled down right now and started typing a comment. If you add asterisks around a word, it makes it bold. If you add underscores, it makes it italicized. And if you add hyphens, it makes it strike through. From your perspective, it looks like it's just plain text. But when you click send, it renders as rich text. BBCode uses a slightly more complex system. Instead of these individual characters like asterisks or underscores, you type a set of brackets and write the name of the effect you want inside. So if I write B, that's the shorthand for bold, then bam, the rest of this text is bold. To end the effect, repeat the brackets, but add a forward slash before the effect name. Here's a list of the most common effects you'll probably want to use. The names are all just a single letter, so it's pretty easy to remember these ones. Plus, these are the effects that let you change stuff about the font the text is using. For changing the font, you have to specify a path to a font resource. And for all the other ones, you have to input a number. For the color modifier, that's going to be the hex code of the color you want to use. These are useful but kinda boring. Let's run through some of the more interesting built-in ones. There's a bunch of formatting effects to be aware of. Of course, there's the different alignment ones for left, right, and center, but there's also effects for adding a horizontal separator, making an ordered list, or making an unordered list. If you wanted to, you could even render a table, which is not something you could do before I started researching for this video. Something to remember about these effects, and really almost all the built-in ones I talk about, is that there's extra settings you can include in each tag. For example, the horizontal separator can have its width, height, or color change. Most of the available options for these effects are documented in the Godot page on BBCode formatting, so I'm not going to really cover them in this video. You can also include URLs in your text, but they might not work the exact way you'd expect them to. Instead of opening the link in your web browser, when you click the link, it calls a signal on the rich text label. You can choose to handle the signal however you'd like. If you want it to work like a normal link, you can do this, but you can also just use it like a regular button if that's something you wanted to do. Oh, and also you can include images in your text. I haven't used this much, as I generally prefer having images as their own node, but if you want to go for a Mario Galaxy style thing where the image of a character is included right next to their name, then this could be nice. And the output panel of Godot's debugger supports rich text, so you could always choose to just spam a bunch of images in there. It certainly makes for a more unique error message. Okay, now let's get to the fun effects. Godot has a few built-in ones just to show you what the engine can do. Pulse, Wave, Tornado, Shake, Fade, and Rainbow. Along with all of these effects are customizable options. For example, with the wave effect, you can change how much each character moves up and down by changing the amplitude, and how quickly the wave passes through by changing the frequency. All of these built-in effects are actually quite easy to make yourself, but to do that, we need to get into custom effects. Finally, in a new empty script, extend the rich text effect class. You can choose to make this a tool script if you want the effect to display in the editor, but you don't have to. Either way, it should work when you actually run the game. Come up with a new class name for your effect. I'll just call mine sample effect. To give a name to the effect, as in the name you'll put in brackets to apply it to your text, create a new member variable called BBCode with the name you want. Finally, all of the code for this effect will be in one function, processCustomEffects. This will be called for every single character. It takes in a charEffects transform, which is how you go about changing the text, and returns a boolean. If you return true, the effect is applied, and if you return false, it basically just ignores whatever changes you made to the character. To make this effect available to your rich text label, go into its markup settings and add a new entry into the custom effects array, and choose the class name of your effect. As you can see, now that the effect is registered, the brackets containing it disappeared, and it is being applied. But currently, it isn't actually doing anything. Instead of showing you the line-by-line process of creating a finished effect, I'm just going to skip ahead to a finished effect that uses most of the features available. Let's break this down. First, I'm changing the character being rendered. This is specified by the charFX glyph index property. I'm making it so the text just says DevPoodle over and over again. A bit conceited, I know. Then I change the color. By using range, you can get the index of the character relative to the whole string of text. This is how to make a rainbow effect, where each character is a different hue. Finally, I'm changing the transform of each character. By setting the offset, you can move each character around. With the charFX elapsed time property, you can also have that change over time. To scale or rotate the characters, you set the charFX transform. So, our plain text is...
Get it twisted. If you lock in, you can do anything. Get it twisted. Your actions impact nothing. Your fate is predetermined. The only thing that you can change is your reaction to it. You can do anything you...
DevPoodle, 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 DevPoodle. Okay, so maybe not the best use of custom effects, but I think you get the idea. Before I leave, I may as well include some slightly more sane custom effects as well. The Godot docs includes two examples, Ghost and Matrix. Here's what they look like. I think they're pretty cool. And these provide a good example of how to add customizable settings into your effects. By calling env.get on your char effects, you can see if the user has specified a setting with this name. The second parameter is the default value, so if no setting was specified, the function will just return 5 in this case. If you're planning to make an effect that you reuse a bunch of times in different contexts, then this can be quite helpful. So, I think I've taught you pretty much everything you need to know to have fun with custom effects in Godot. A link to the main doc page on BBCode effects is in the description. There's bound to be a lot more details there that I didn't have time to cover. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And as always, I appreciate whatever questions or suggestions you may have in the comment section below. I'm DevPoodle, and isn't there some sort of phrase about not wearing a name out? Whatever. DevPoodle, 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 DevPoodle. Oh, this bit sucks. Why'd I have to write it so many times? DevPoodle, DevPoodle, Oh, well, at least it'll be hard to forget now. DevPoodle, 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 DevPoodle.